Hello, and welcome to the interior inspection of a Class C school bus. When we do the interior inspection, we're going to start left to right. We're going to go up to down and back. Okay, so I just got in the bus. Okay, and let's do a little pretend. The inspector also comes in the bus as well. Okay, and the engine is off right now. So, this is what I'm going to do, okay? I'm going to tell the inspector, we'll start from the driver's side door, okay? The inspector is sitting down, okay? And he's going to, or she's going to want to see you to do your lights, okay? So ask the inspector to check the exterior lights, and the inspector will go out. You're going to put your key in the ignition, turn the engine on. Do a safe start. Okay, make sure your parking brake is on. Okay. Do your right turn signal, your left turn signal, your low beams, high beams, four ways. Okay, and your student lights. That's your ambers and then your reds. Okay, what the inspector's checking for to see the light bulbs are working and the gate comes out. He will walk behind back, okay, and then again, you're going to do the same thing. You're going to do your left turn signal, right turn signal, step on the brake for the rear, your emergencies, and then your student lights. Amber, red, okay. Then he's gonna come back in and sit down, and then he's going to say start. So what you wanna do at this point, being you've turned the engine on already, we're gonna leave it on, okay? And we're gonna start from here. Okay, tell the inspector that the, you look at your dashboard is clean, your ABS light went out, do your gauges, your oil should come up to around 40, right here it's probably around 30, the bottom one is your temperature gauge, around 210, your speedometer, tell him you're going to test it when you test your gas pedal because that's when the knob will go up. This is your voltmeter or your battery should come up to 14, and your gas, you have gas in the tank there. Okay, but I also want you to do your door, open and close your door. Say the door opens and closes properly. Window, open and close properly, clean, not cracked. Handle, secure to the frame of the bus, clean, not cracked. Put your seatbelt on. Seatbelt secure to the frame of the bus. Seatbelt not worn or torn here. Driver's seat secure to the frame of the bus. No missing nuts or bolts. At this time, you also check your mirrors just to make sure they're properly adjusted. And they are, they're clean. Go to your, what I call your vitals, okay? And in your vitals, actually, they're up here, okay. Check your registration and your insurance certificate. Tell the inspector that it's up to date. Put it back in. Your motor vehicle inspection report is up to date. If there were any repairs that had to be made, they were made and they were okay. And they're signed by the driver. And your children's list, up to date. It has all the names, the addresses, and the phone numbers. Okay, back. Okay, so we're gonna continue with the inspection here. Let's start, we did your dashboard. Okay, again, I'm going to check the lights. what they're looking for is the interior bulb is working. That's the right turn signal. Left turn signal is working. Your high beam signal is working. And your four ways interior bulbs are working properly. Okay, this is your dimmer switch here, working properly, low, high. Okay. Let's go to your steering wheel. Okay, no more than 2 inches or 10 degrees on a 20-inch wheel. Just do that. Your horn works properly. We're going to go to the next set of things to point out to the inspector, and that's your park brake, your service brake, your gas pedal, and your transmission gear. What they're looking for is to check for tension and stickiness. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is check the park brake, which is on. It's on when you do a safe start. Okay, so I'm gonna put the bus in go or to drive. I'm gonna drive a little bit and it holds. Okay, and tell the inspector that the park brake is working properly, it's not sticking, and also that your transmission gear is not sticking as well. Okay, the next thing is your service brake. Just want to go up and down like that. Okay, and we're going to take the park brake off, put into drive, go a little bit, stop. Service brake working properly, not sticking, and the tension is just right. And when doing so, you also can test the gas pedal. I'll test it again, being I didn't do it at the same time. Put the gear in drive, step on the gas pedal a little bit, not sticking. And the gas pedal works fine. Okay, so let's go on to your windshield. Okay, your windshield is clean, not cracked, no illegal stickers, and your inspection sticker is up to date. You have your wipers. Okay, test low, high, and then the water fluid. Okay, there's fluid in there. The tension is proper on your wipers. Okay, if the tension was too hard, you could possibly crack your windshield. If it was too light, you'd have streaks all over the place. Okay, so we did that. Your windshield, your mirrors. Okay, shut that off. This is your driver mirror. Okay, tell the inspector it's clean, not cracked, secure to the frame of the bus. You can see straight down the aisle to about 200 feet behind. And that's your driver mirror. Your overhead mirror, secure to the frame of the bus. You can see all the students' heads straight back, again to about 200 feet behind. Okay, this is your visor. Goes up and down proper, blocks the sun, right? And secure to the frame of the bus. Let's go to your heat. Low, high, heat working properly. Your defrost, low, high, working properly. Okay, just put your hand over there. This is a sensor camera. It works when somebody isn't directly in front of the bus. It beeps, okay? And you'll hear that when you use your student lights. And also, on your driver mirror, you have a camera. That works when you are backing up. That's a backing camera. Okay, so your electrical panel here, okay? And your mirrors, okay? I'm going to test each one. This is your left flat mirror. Works properly, goes up and down. The mirror's not cracked, clean. Okay, and the bottom is your convex mirror. To get your convex mirror, turn it to the right. Up, down, works properly. You want the mirrors adjusted to see around 15 feet of the side of your bus, and the bottom mirrors have to see the rear tires in the back. This one here is your right convex mirror, up and down, moves up and down properly. Okay, this one here is your flat mirror. Same thing, okay, you want them adjusted properly to see about 15 feet of the sides of the bus, and the bottom ones to see the rear tire in view, okay. This button here is your defroster to those mirrors. Okay, and by the way, the two mirrors in the front are called your crossover mirrors. You basically want to see about 15 feet in front of the bus by the gate. You have to be clean and not cracked in any way. This is your AC fan. It turns on in the back, low, high. This is your compressor to it. This will bring the cold out. This is your fan up here, working properly. These are your driver dome lights. Lights are working properly. These are your rear dome lights, and they're working properly. Okay. This is your heater, your rear heater, low, high, working properly. This is a strobe light, okay? That's a light on top of the bus in the back. It is white. Okay, if you push it in, you turn it on. If you push it down, you turn it off. Okay, it's working properly. Otherwise, you wouldn't see that little red thing there. These here is your master switch, okay? And your master switch you use when you're picking up or dropping off kids. Turn it on. Those are your ambers, working properly. And your reds. Your reds, open the door. Reds working properly. Open the door. Okay, this is an override switch to that. To get this button to work, you're going to turn this on, hit the override, and the reds will come out and you don't need to open the door. The switch is working properly. Failure to call out the electrical panel, you will result in a failure. Okay, I'm going to shut that off. Okay, so we're working over this way. Okay, this is your handle to your door. Open and close. Working properly. Secure to the frame of the bus. No missing nuts or bolts here. This is a seatbelt cutter used to get the kids out in case you have an emergency. We did the fan. Okay. You can get out of your seat inside the bus and leave the key in the ignition when you are in the bus. When you exit the bus, you must take the key and put it in your pocket, but we're not going to exit the bus right now. Okay, so this handle, again, secure to the frame of the bus. These handles over here, secure to the frame of the bus, no missing nuts or bolts. Stairwell has to be clean, okay? And anything underneath by your feet has to be clean, okay? The light in good condition, not cracked or broken, that usually comes on when somebody enters the bus. Okay. So we did the door, okay. Inside of the door, clean, not cracked in any way. Bumper, secure to the frame of the bus. Your emergencies. Okay, is your first aid kit, secure to the frame of the bus. Your body fluid cleanup kit, secure to the frame of the bus. Your ABC fire extinguisher, in the green. Inspection tag up to date. Secure to the frame of the bus. When we say in the green, the needle must be in the green there. Sometimes they'll ask you to read it. Okay, sometimes they won't, but you can see the number there. This bus does not have to have three fuses because we have a circuit breaker box, which is in the engine. Okay, then we have over here, You have your three reflective flares when you use an emergency. The box itself is secured to the frame of the bus. Okay, and then, so, did the handle. Okay, as we go back, this aisle has to be clean and free of obstruction. Okay, and under the seats and all that. And then we do a general around the back. Just tell the inspector that there's no missing nuts or bolts here. And in appearance, the windows look clean and they're gonna open and close properly. When you go back, call out every seat and every seat cushion, touch it. Say seat secure to the frame of the bus, no missing nuts or bolts. Seat cushion, not ripped. Seat belt, not worn or torn, okay? You can go to the window, because you have to call out every window. Say the window not cracked, clean. Window open and closed properly. Okay. Let's do the next one. Seat cushion, not worn or torn. Seat, secure to the frame of the bus, no missing nuts or bolts. Seat belt, in good condition, not worn or torn. The window, clean, not cracked. Open and closes properly. Okay. Open and close every window as you go back. This one too. Okay. There we go. Open and closes properly. Clean, not cracked. Okay. Again, seat secure to the frame of the bus, no missing nuts or bolts. Cushion not worn or torn. Seatbelt in good condition, not worn or torn. And then check the window, clean, not cracked. Open and closes properly. Same thing on this side. Okay. Some people do their emergencies last, which we're going to do ours last, because the emergencies on this bus open two ways. Same thing with this window. Open and close properly, clean, not cracked. Repeat the same procedure for this seat and the last one. Seat secure to the frame of the bus, no missing nuts or bolts. Seat belt, not worn or torn, in good condition. Cushion in good condition, not ripped. And then check your windows, okay? Go to this one first, clean, not cracked. Open and close properly. Okay. And same thing with this one here. It's supposed to open and close properly. There we go. Clean, not cracked. Repeat the same thing for the last seat. Cushion in good condition. Seat secure to the frame of the bus. Not broken in any way. No missing nuts or bolts. Seat belt, not worn or torn. Okay, then you got your windows. Except for the emergencies, which we're going to do in a minute. This is the rear heater grill. Clean, not cracked in any way, no missing nuts or bolts. Your bumper secure to the bus. Proper signage for your emergency door. Okay, let's go down to the handle. On this bus, and on many buses, your ignition has to be turned on when you open the emergencies. Failure to not turn your ignition on will result in a failure in your test, because what the examiners look for is hearing the siren. Okay, so handle secure to the frame of the bus, no missing nuts or bolts here. Let's open the door. I'm gonna hear the sound. Say the window's clean, proper signage, okay. Handle secure to the frame of the bus. Okay, and then you're gonna open and close it. Again, the inspector's looking for the siren. The engine must be on in this bus for the siren to play. Okay, so if you have it off by any chance and the siren doesn't go, they can fail you for that. So remember, the engine must be on when you're checking the emergencies. Okay, so we're going to go to the emergency window next. Proper signage. Clean, not broken in any way. Okay, it opens two ways. up and down like this, and then out like that. Okay, whoops. Okay. Show the inspector the two ways that it opens, okay? The other window over here, again, clean, not broken in any way. Goes up and down like that, and then opens and closes properly. Okay? And you will be asked to do your emergency hatch, okay? So here's a procedure for that. Okay, so you to open the emergency hatch, what you have to do is this. Okay, turn it this way. Then, you're going to push the knob in and push it up like that. Push it up with your hand, okay? Because you want to say to the inspector that the kids have to get out. So, to close it, you're going to line the hatch up in the grooves here. Okay, see how it goes in the grooves? Pull it down with your hand, two hand, like this. Turn it to close, okay? And that's the emergency hatch. You'll be asked to do at least one. This bus has two, okay? So then you're gonna walk up at the end. You're gonna come up, and just when you think you're done with the inspection, you're not. Sit down in your seat, okay? Turn the engine off, take the key out, put it in one, turn it one. Okay, get up, walk back, tell the inspector that you're checking the seats for children that are sleeping, okay? Go back to the child lock, hold it in 3 seconds, uno, dos, tres. Take your hand off, okay? Come back up, okay, sit down, take the key out, and then you're done with the inspection.